in January, and whoever wins on Saturday night will be the true WBA champion. No question about it.
All right. Thanks very much, Keith. Our next question is going to come from Erica Montoya. Erica, please unmute yourself and you can ask your question.
Hi, guys. Good afternoon. It's a pleasure to talk with you. My question is for both. What are the complications of such an emblematic fight taking place 10 days from now? You have to adapt the way you train, your strategy.
Thank you, Erica. I answer first. In my side, I always consider myself a bipartisan boxer, and I like fighting right-handers and southpaws. So it's not a problem, gonna be a problem to me. I've been fighting with right-handed, so it's not gonna be a problem. Thank you, Erika.
Bueno, thank you, Manny. Jordanis, la pregunta de Erika era, ¿qué tanto te complica este cambio de último minuto en cuanto a la estrategia, a la preparación? Por ejemplo, Manny dijo que a él no lo complicó en lo más mínimo porque él está acostumbrado a pelear contra diestros y contra zurdos por igual. Pero en tu caso, ¿cómo te impactó este último momento?
Sí, es un problema de hacer los cambios. Como te digo, peleé hace 4 años en Mayweather, peleé con 10 días con Duloma cuando Poirier se quitó. Después peleé un día de antelación en un show de Fotomay. Estoy acostumbrado a pelear, peleé muchas peleas aficionado con derecho y zurdo. Esto es solamente hacer un par de ajustes y seguimos adelante en la pelea.
It's not last minute changes are nothing that I'm not used to, and it's just about making the adjustments. I had to make it a couple of times before where I was told that something was going to change at the last minute. Like 4 years ago, I remember I had to do that same thing, and I was able to adjust that same way. Also, a couple of years ago, same issue. So now I'm ready to adjust to whatever comes my way.
All right. Thanks very much, Erica. Our next question is going to come from Chris Matthews with KLAS TV in Las Vegas. Chris, please unmute yourself and you can ask your question.
All right. Thank you very much, guys. Appreciate you doing this. I guess for Manny, if you had to sell this, if for the fans who were excited to see you fight Spence, and now there was an about face in your fight and the other guy, as a promoter, as a guy trying to sell the fight, to get your fans excited about this fight, what would you say, how would you promote this fight to the boxing fans out there who now have to get ready for a different fight?
What I can say to the fans is this fight is not an easy fight. August is he's a champion. He took my belt and we have to settle it inside the ring. You know, I never take him lightly with this August fight, because August is he's a kind of fighter that you cannot underestimate. So this is gonna be a good fight also. I mean, August and Spence is similar and same tall, so nothing changed. Different style. Southpaw and right-handed.
And then for Ugas, I'd like to just ask you kind of a question just on the opportunity that you have to fight a person like Manny Pacquiao, who has accomplished so much, and the opportunity to beat a guy like this. What does that mean to you?
Jordanis, ¿qué significa para vos el enfrentar a un campeón de la talla, del calibre de Manny Pacquiao?
Significa mucho, todo legado. Estoy aquí por mi legado. No tomo la pelea por dinero, estoy tomando la pelea por mi legado. Significa mucho tener todos los peleadores de ustedes tener una oportunidad contra Manny Pacquiao. Yo la tengo ahora ahí. Y esto es por mi legado, por mi historia, por mi país. Todo una pelea más grande de mi vida.
This means the world to me, Chris. I'm fighting not for the money, but for my legacy, for my country, for my own, for my own story that's going to be told. That's what it's about to me. This is the most important fight of my life.
All right. Thanks very much, Chris. Our next question is going to come from Jeremy Harridges with Fansided. Jeremy, please unmute yourself and you can ask your question.
Hi, Manny. Hi, you're Dennis. First question's for Manny. Obviously, the WBA has made a lot of moves with the welterweight title, rescinding titles, elevating titles. Does that provide you any extra motivation going into this fight?
Yeah. There's a lot of, people around me, and reason that motivate me to win this fight. So, a lot of reason, but I will not say that reason. One thing is, of course, my family expecting me to win the fight, and the support of the fans, and of course, the enjoyment of the fans who are going to watch in the arena.
You're Dennis. I know that a lot of people are going to be looking at you as the underdog in this fight. What would you say is your biggest weapon in this fight, and why should people be looking at you as not an underdog?
¿Por qué la gente no te debería ver como un como que vas de, en Argentina decimos que vas de punto y no de banca, o sea, de por qué no te deberían considerar alguien que va de menos, o sea, por qué deberías ser considerado el favorito?
Repite la pregunta. Repite la pregunta.
¿Por qué? O sea, obviamente en esta pelea no te consideran el favorito, pero ¿por qué crees que están equivocados? Por qué Yordanis Lucas debería ser el favorito en esta pelea?
No, soy un peleador que viene peleando, regresé hace 5 años. Hace 5 años subí a 147, tenía 15-3. Estaba peleado con lo mejor que se me ha puesto. Debía ser un campeón en el 2019 cuando me jugaron la pelea con Porte. Seguí peleando, gané el campeonato. Aquí estaba fuera del deporte y me elevaron a supercampeón. Soy un campeón. Siento, sí, Pacquiao favorito. Tiene una gran historia. Yo soy un peleador que viene a ganar y a sorprender el mundo esa noche.
Well, look, I'm well aware that Pacquiao is the favorite, but at the same time, I'm a champion. Ever since I came back 5 years ago, I have overcome so much. I have had fights stolen from me. I've fought really strong opponents, and I have just gone through everything in order to get to where I am today. So even though Manny is the favorite, I have full confidence in myself and my ability to come out with a victory on Saturday night.
Thank you, gentlemen, and best of luck.
All right. Thanks, Jeremy. Our next question is going to come from Dan Rayfield. Dan, please unmute yourself and you can ask your question.
Thank you very much, guys. Appreciate that. Or Dennis, my first question is for you, Martin, if you could ask him. He had a 2-year layoff between 2014 and 16 after he had suffered a couple of losses and then came back and moved up. And I wondered, first off, if he could just talk about a little bit what he was doing during the 2-year layoff in terms of his mentality of we would fight again. And if at that time, which I think was probably a low point in his career, you'd ever imagine that not only would have these types of opportunities, have a belt and, you know, be fighting a legend like Manny Pacquiao.
Okay, so it's a 2-for-1 question, right? First, what he was doing, and then what it means to him, like, to have this opportunity at this point in his career, correct?
Right. In other words, did he ever think at the time of that layoff, in that downtime, that he could be back in this level of an event?
Bueno, Yordanis, contanos un poco lo que hiciste durante ese parate entre 2014 y 2016 y también si en aquel entonces te imaginabas que 5 años después estarías donde estás ahora, peleando contra Pacquiao por el título.
No, en 2014 tuve 2 derrotas, me fui para mi casa, tuve 2 años y medio fuera, haciendo otras cosas, tuve mi hijo, organicé y sabía que podía dar mucho. No pensé que iba a pelear con Pacquiao defendiendo un campeonato. Eso nunca lo pasé, pero sí pensé que podía hacer mucho en el deporte. Y eso es lo que yo he hecho desde que regresé. Siento que he sido uno de los peleadores más activos y mejores peleadores en los últimos años.
Well, Dan, when I came back, when I went away from boxing after a couple of losses in 2014, I focused on family. I wanted to spend time with my kid more than anything, my son. That's what was most important to him. And to be honest with you, back then, I would have never thought that 7 years later, I would be fighting against Manny Pacquiao, defending a title. But, you know, the past 5 years, I have been one of the most active, one of the most successful, one of the most prominent boxers out there. And I'm here to prove myself once again.
Oh, very good. And I had a question also for Manny. Manny, it's good to talk to you. Manny, I know you addressed a little earlier Keith's question about the WBA situation, but I wonder, in any way, do you feel like this should be your title defense? I mean, you won the title against Thurman, and now they tell you you're not the actual WBA champion, and that it should, in fact, be a title defense for you, and that does that in any way upset you, that technically you're the challenger here?
I think this fight is going to be defined as going to be hold the belt, and which is it's happening this way, so this is good. I mean, I'm so excited for this championship fight. I don't care if this is the champion or I'm the champion or no, but let's finish this fight first, and then we will see who's the title holder.
Okay, and if you win the fight, I don't even know if you realize this, when you beat Keith Thurman at age 40, you became the oldest fighter in the history of boxing to win a welterweight championship. Now that you're technically the challenger here, if you beat Ugas at age 42, you'll break your own record. What would that mean to you to have such another feather in your cap?
That's very good. That's very good because I'm myself breaking my own record.
You like that, right?
I like that. Making history.
Great. Thanks, Dan. Our next question is going to come from Farah Parrett with Telemundo. Farah, please unmute yourself and you can ask your question.
Yes, thank you so much. So Manny Pacquiao, this is another fight in your amazing career. What will you think that people want, what you would like for people to think about Manny Pacquiao, not only as a boxer, but in your personal life and career? What do you want people to remember you as?
The most important thing that I want people to remember me is Manny Pacquiao is a friendly, is a nice guy and an inspiration to everyone, not only inside the ring, but outside the ring as a human. Especially showing the love to each other and compassionate to each other. So that's one I want them to remember me. Not only in boxing.
Thank you. And for Ugas, me gustaría saber qué representa para la comunidad cubana ahora mismo tener a una figura de su país en estos tiempos que necesitan ese apoyo moral, espiritual, política, pelear con Manny Pacquiao, ¿qué significa para ti y qué mensaje tú quisieras darle a la comunidad, no solamente del boxeo, sino a la comunidad cubana?
Sí, todo el mundo sabe que soy un peleador por los derechos de mi país, soy un peleador contra la dictadura de mi país, todo el mundo sabe que levanto mi voz muy alta contra eso todo el tiempo. Y esta pelea, una plataforma increíble para yo lanzar lo que tenemos los cubanos, que es patria y vida, y pedirle un mejor país, libertad para todos los presos políticos. Y esta pelea es una oportunidad increíble para esas cosas.
The question from Farah was, what's it mean to you to be fighting against Manny Pacquiao, not just for yourself, but for the people in your country, in Cuba, that are going through hard times? And Jordani replied that, you know, I'm a fighter not only inside the ring, but outside of it. I fight against the dictatorship. I fight for the freedom of my people. I fight for the freedom of the political prisoners that are in jail right now. And, you know, there's a saying in Cuba called Patria y Vida. It's basically a country and life, right? So that's who I fight for, my people. That's the most important thing to me. And I hope everyone is safe and, you know, fighting for their freedom right now. And I'll be fighting for them on Saturday.
All right. Thank you, Farah. Our next question is going to come from Manouk Kopian with the LA Times. Manouk, please unmute yourself and you can ask your question.
Hi, Manny. You're taking this fight on 11 days' notice, and as everyone knows, you became a name overnight when you took a fight on short notice against Lilo Laguava in 2000. Are you concerned to repeat a version of history against you?
No, I'm not. I'm not worried about that because it's happened that way. That Jordanis Ogas is under he's the undercard, so. My case before is I wasn't in the undercard. I wasn't in the card, so I'm just a substitute on that fight. So I think this time around, I know Ogas is also prepared for this fight because he's undercard. So he's in training. Good. It's happened. You know, we cannot avoid it. What's happening right now.
Did you consider at any point canceling the fight altogether, or you did not want to waste any more time or more importantly, a training camp at this point of your career?
Considering cancel the fight. Yeah, I mean, if there is no Ogas in the undercard, there's no the same weight in the my undercard. I think probably the fight will be canceled, but it happened that way. It's a good thing that Ugas is the same weight in welterweight division and under he's undercard. So it happened that there's an injury in our opponent. So why we don't fight each other? So to settle down, who's the WBA champion? So that's the question.
Thank you very much.
All right, thanks, Manouk. Our next question is going to come from Katia Castorena with ESPN Deportes. Katia, please unmute yourself and you can ask your question.
Thank you. For sure, Manny. Manny, it's been 25 months since we last saw you on the ring. So what can we expect from you and how do you feel physically?
I'm excited. Very excited for the coming fight on August 21. It's been a while that I didn't have a fight, so this is gonna be exciting and can't wait.
Y Jordanis, ¿qué versión esperas de Manny también en el plano físico por el tema de la edad y por el tema de que hace poco más de 2 años desde la última vez que lo vimos arriba del ring?
¿Jordanis?
Sí.
¿Escuchaste la pregunta?
Sí, escuché. No, espero el mejor Manny Pacquiao. Me estoy preparando para el mejor Manny Pacquiao. Un peleador que siempre viene en la mejor forma. Siempre ha dado grandes actuaciones. Y no puedo... es un error el que lo pueda subestimar. Un guerrero y viene y lo estoy preparado para...
So Katia's question was what your Dennis expects out of Manny considering the 25 month layoff between fights for him. And your Dennis said that underestimating Manny Pacquiao is absolutely out of question. He's gonna be ready. I expect the best Manny Pacquiao to be out there on the ring, and that's my premise. I have prepared to face the best, to be the best.
Thank you.
Gracias, Katia.
All right. Thank you, Katia. Our last question is going to come from Mark Lonwala with Sporting News. Mark, please unmute yourself. You can ask your question.
Hey, Manny, because you've trained for Spence this entire time and because of this late opponent change and Ugas's aggressive style, how dangerous of a fight is this for you?
I think... the only adjustment that I have to make is for this fight is the southpaw and the right-handed. So that's the only thing because Errol Spence is aggressive also, and Ogas is aggressive. So that's good. I mean, we can create more action in the ring. the fans will love it.
Thank you, Manny. And Uga, Dennis, I'd like to pose a similar question to you. On such short notice, how much of a threat can you pose to Manny with your style?
Bueno, la pregunta de Mark es, ¿qué tan amenazado, qué tanto te consideras como amenaza para Manny Pacquiao con tu estilo, considerando que también esta pelea es de último minuto?
Dime la parte final.
O sea, considerando que esta pelea es de último minuto, ¿qué tan peligroso te consideras para Manny? Con tu estilo, además, tu estilo agresivo. Manny decía recién que él seas agresivo, de la misma manera que él esperaba que Spence sea agresivo.
Bueno, yo soy un peleador que viene a pelear, un peleador que viene a dejarlo todo, a dejar todo esa noche ahí, la noche más grande de mi carrera. Comencé el boxeo a los 6 años. Pienso que lo que están apoyándome, pienso que no lo voy a decepcionar.
How much of a threat am I going to be? I can tell you that I'm not going to disappoint the fans that are supporting me. This is the most important fight of my life. I started fighting when I was 6 years old, dreaming of this. And I'm going to be ready to step to the ring and give my all. I'm gonna leave it all inside the ring. And no matter what happens, that's gonna be my goal. Leave it all out there, and whatever happens, happens.
All right. Thanks very much, Mark. For the press that are inquiring about it, we are gonna send around a recording of this after the fact. But for now, I'll turn it back over to Ray. We'll get the closing comments from the fighters and wrap it up.
All right. Thank you very much, Andrew. And thank you very much to the media for joining us. Don't forget, Manny Pacquiao, your Dennis Ugas for the Welterweight Championship of the World next Saturday, August 21, T-Mobile Arena in Las Vegas on Fox Sports PBC pay-per-view, brought to you by MP Promotions and TGB Promotions. Also, this, from the oddsmaker standpoint, it opened up as a 2-1 favorite in favor of Manny Pacquiao. So the oddsmakers, at least when it opened up, they feel that it is going to be a rather close fight. We anticipate a great night of boxing next Saturday in Las Vegas. First of all, I will leave it up to your Dennis Ugas with final comments as he gets set to take on the 8-division world champion in Manny Pacquiao. And also for your Dennis, a message to the fans. Martín?
Your Dennis, bueno, comentarios finales sobre enfrentar a Manny el sábado 21 y además un mensaje que les quieras dar a todos los aficionados que te van a ver pelear tanto en Estados Unidos como en Cuba y alrededor del mundo.
Sí, que esto sea una gran pelea. Le vamos a regalar una gran pelea a todos los fanáticos. Quiero mandarle un mensaje especialmente a los cubanos. Esta lucha va dedicada a todos los hombres y mujeres que quieren un cambio para nuestro país. Todos los hombres y mujeres que cada día luchan por la libertad en nuestro país. Esta lucha, voy a luchar con el corazón para dedicarle esa lucha a ese pueblo cubano con deseo un cambio, a todos los hombres y mujeres que están luchando por la libertad de nuestro país.
I can guarantee that this is going to be an amazing fight. Both Manny and I will leave it all out there, and that's going to be our gift to the fans. And I also want to send a greeting to the fans in Cuba, sending my best to all the men and women that are fighting for freedom, that are fighting for change. And I'm going to leave my heart out there for you. And that's my promise.
All right. Thank you very much, your Dennis. And for Manny Pacquiao, the 8-division world champion, once again, take hold of his WBA welterweight championship as he takes on the champion, your Dennis Ugas. Manny, your thoughts as you get set to collide against your Dennis Ugas 10 days from now.
Thank you for this opportunity to promote the fight. I'd like to say to the fans, please watch this fight and miss it. It's going to be a good fight. I'm not taking lightly for Ugas. Ugas is a good fighter and he's aggressive. I'm sure we can create more action in the ring and make the fans happy. And don't miss it. It's going to be a good fight. And I hope to see you in Vegas on August 21. Thank you, everyone, and to all the media, press, for always supporting and promoting boxing.
Thank you very much to your Dennis Ugas and Manny Pacquiao, the division world champion. Thank you to the media and thank you to all the PR members and all the members of the promotional staff involved. We appreciate it. And we will see you next week in Las Vegas for Manny Pacquiao going head-to-head against your Dennis Ugas on Fox Sports PBC pay-per-view. Have a great rest of your afternoon. And we'll see you next week in the fighting capital of the world.
Recording stopped.